Firstly, I will speak to you about the word in the Bible.
Luke 8.
We are going to read in the book of Luke chapter 18.
Chapter 8, verse 22.
Then this afternoon of today, when I read you in the Bible, I was hearing about Jesus Christ. They said he entered into the ark. When they were referring to what he said from the other Bible, they were talking about Jesus Christ. They are talking about a ship. He said, let's go to another or abroad. They went abroad. When they were in the middle, before they went where they are going, they saw floods. By the time Jesus Christ was asleep, when they looked, they saw storm and floods. When they saw that it would make them or mistake them, they called Jesus Christ and say, wake up. How can we die? And then it stopped.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When I read through this Bible, when he was speaking to me, there are places where we are going. There is abroad where we have to go. I ask myself a question. I ask you to a question. Whatever that your God has, who are you going to do with? I never had answers by myself. They said I must come and encourage you by receiving God. The one who believe and get baptized will be the same. You will be saved.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When I look into this, I found that you have to receive Jesus. You have to receive the man Jesus. The man in. The one who will walk with you. Because you cannot go abroad without him. My friend, today I'm encouraging you to take Jesus. You might be an attender of church. You have taken a big step of entering into church. But one thing you have to do, you have to receive Jesus. You cannot walk alone by yourself without Jesus. If you receive Jesus, You won't be like today. Whatever how people know you, you won't be like that. Your character shall change. Whatever that you are, you shall change. If you receive Jesus, if you take the inner man, when people look unto you, they will see a changed character. Your walking shall change. Your attire shall change. The way you live shall change. You won't be someone who is always angry. You won't have anger. Why is there something which making you to make a mistake? When your child break a glass, you have anger inside you. When you take Jesus, there will be no such anger. No matter inside church, when somebody speaks by you in another way, you won't hear it. Because your ear will be deaf. You'll be having the man Jesus. If you receive the man Jesus and be a walker inside everywhere, no matter what you speak, you shall say. No matter how wrong they have done in your family matters, why do you have that anger inside you? You are speaking inside yourself and saying, mine doesn't have anything. From the left side when I come, from the right side it goes that side. There is not any man who will look at me. Hey you. You don't need any heart but of flesh. You need the man Jesus. If you receive the man Jesus, you will never need any man. You will need only Jesus. What is wrong by your son? At your job, you are not paid a good salary. The word of God says, the one who believes, he will be saved. Hey you, take the man Jesus and say, Lord, my husband or the man I work, the man will stand up. You will fight all your battles. I'm calling you to do so. Let me tell you something which is not going according to the way. When they are stressed, they'll say, let me get something to drink. That one thing is Jesus. That one thing is Jesus. Never take the thing. Take the man Jesus. Maybe your child is the one you already have. The one you sit with, to hold, never go with him. Go to your family, Jesus, and say, Jesus, this child is disrespectful. The child that I gave back to you when you are here alive is highly impossible. My friend, today I came here breaking you, begging you with my two hands. Take Jesus. When you take Jesus, you won't enter from this side to that side. Amen. The one in me is greater than the one in the world. Because when you tell Jesus, you are the King of Kings. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Stand up on your feet. I'm not going to make a village around when it's not another one. They got over it. I didn't have an answer yet, so come on, Jerry. I don't know. So I want you to open your mouth and begin to pray. But your hope and the Jehovah should be hunger. The Jehovah, but then you hunger, the Jehovah, your hope. Begin to pray, somebody begin to pray, say something. Oh, yes, Lord, oh, yes, Lord.
You may be seated in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my Savior. I want you to allow Mother Apostle to honor the anointing of the house in the mighty name of Jesus. Honor the anointing of the house in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When we are going to the book of Luke 6:38. Give and you shall be given back. Give, you shall be given back. Whatever that you shall give to others, and they shall do so.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's give hands for Jesus. To speak to some lady. I want to speak to some.
Hey,
I'm talking to you. Whatever that you're supposed to give, the one that you're giving to others, and it shall be given back to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. In this afternoon, I want you to take out whatever you are carrying. Whatever that you have with you,
I
don't know whether if you're understanding, whatever that you want God to do for you in this afternoon, truly I'm telling you, I want to prophesy in your life.
You are
the one.
Kwa Come on, Rimba, mascot, tap on, mascot, then we can.
Yeah. Let me honor the anointing of my father. And the mother of this house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are in the presence of God. We are in the presence of God. We are about to worship God. Before I go any further, let me tell you something. That you don't need a reason to worship God. You don't need a reason to worship God.
Yeah.
Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Beloved of all heaven, I greet you all.
Amen.
Amen.
What a wonderful day.
Greet your neighbor and say, Dovalabudi.
What a wonderful day.
What a wonderful day, neighbor.
In the presence of God.
Kurumeni
Saha. Vandana Vamzim Vote Varahonia.
I greet all men of God here in the presence.
Banondo.
Sorry.
Banondo.
All the men of God of this house.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Na vote bakidalomzim.
And all pastors who are here.
You are so much appreciated for you to be part of this service.
Ri parish huri seno ribu wa musibona ngoko na bachipinda cha ino service.
Prophet Isaiah Karavandere Zanda.
Prophet Isaiah, let's give him to you.
Dynamite Karavandere Zanda.
The Dynamite, let's give him to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In actual fact, Dynamite built that
Okay, when did I? Okay, was it much better?
I'm a Vandere Zanda. I want to move from Vandere Zanda at the pool.
Can we hear it again for him to stand up?
Who wanted to say, Philip Zimor of the Funds?
Yeah.
I want to move from Vandere Zanda.
We want to preach everything for him.
All
is well in the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Zumunikos.
God is the King.
Amen.
Amen.
Mother
of Wabudi.
I salute the Spirit in you. I'm not apologetic. To say I'm a coach. I'm not apologetic.
That he is a coach.
No, he's a coach.
He is called to coach.
I'm a spiritual coach.
Amen. Is on him.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
These are the impact of attending Bible studies.
Jesus, you told me I was going to That's why I say I stay the spirit inside you. Of hearing you, what your coach has said.
I'm not apologetic to say I am an apostle of this vision. I'm the new vision apostle.
Amen. Zanda na kuwa kulu. Zanda na chita chitu. Zanda zuhuri chinita.
I cannot apologize for that. Amen.
Amen.
We are going straight to the word of God. In actual fact, I just want to speak a little bit.
He won't preach much. The pastor and the one
who
has already preached. He's not going to preach, he's just going to preach a little bit.
We are going Genesis chapter 43.
We are going to the book of Genesis chapter 43.
Verse 30.
Okay. We are going to open in the book of Genesis chapter 43 until to verse 30. It reads.
43. Genesis 43.
Verse 30. Then Joseph hurried from the room because he was overcome with the emotion for his brother. He went to his private room where he broke down and wept after washing his face. He came back out, keeping himself under control. Then he ordered bring out the food.
Joseph arubona muratuwa we, zari tambiriya we. Atavanya apelanda atota wone angazula wone alira. Achena fumuni ya we alira on. Atamba kufeni. Atova averanda adukatis are avane zelewa. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God Almighty, Lord God Powerful, indeed you are Jehovah, Porto Grato, Elash Maya, Vrais, your name, you are Abba. We call you Elgiba, Eshokla, Shama, Shalom, Sabov. All these, Jehovah, you are who you were, you are, and you're still going to be. In the name which is above our names, Father, we pray and say, be here with us in all my God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
The book of Genesis.
In the book of Genesis,
the
one which was written by Moses
between 1450
in the between Gamgamga Nunga, you are 1450
to 1410 before Christ.
We are 1410 before Christ.
1410 BC.
1410 BC.
In other words, BC means before Christ.
Then when the Helen BC will be born, who is to die as a Christ?
Who is to baby was yes?
Before Jesus Christ was born.
Yes, so as a to the horn.
Musia Jesus Christ was not born.
Now these are the words that was written by Moses.
I am the mama mighty Amaronga Musia.
Some time back.
Mama again Rao.
There was a man called Joseph. This Joseph.
A young man who was loved
by the father. Now the Bible says,
the Bible one of the days, he was sold by his brothers. He was sold to the Benjamins. The Benjamin sold him to the Egyptians.
Listen to me.
Cried in front of his enemies.
The
heart was broken.
Was
There is power in your tears.
In
Luke chapter 18. vhathu vha fha power yo u isa phanḓa ngori vha ya ḓivha uri vhone vha vha kona gai. There is power in your tears. That's only when I come and see. Because there's only said power that is in your tears. When you are a machine, you are giving them the opportunity. They will give them the opportunity.
When you do this, you cry.
When you do this, you cry.
When you do this, you become weak. The Bible says, when Joseph was done crying, he went outside with a
spear.
He made himself
strong.
He knows that he's going to
be able to
the people who saw him. The one who has hurt you, you show and say, you have hurt me. That's why he will repeat and make a revenge again. Because he knows your weak spot. He doesn't know the God in you. He doesn't trust the God in you. Yes, Jesus. Hey!
Today, I feel shame to enemies. I feel shame to haters. I feel shame to those who attack. I feel shame to them. Because
when she or he tries in all the way he can try, when you meet that person that she knows, give him a smile or her a smile. You have to know,
but don't show them. Listen to me, your battle, it's a spiritual battle. Physically,
yeah, no,
we confuse them. Raise your hands high. The presence of God is in this place. The presence of God is in this place. Listen to me.
Stop knowing much of your enemy.
Better than the power of God behind you. You must know the power of God behind you. So I want you to go and pray.
And when you go away, it's at a bed.
This afternoon, in the presence of God. This is my last Sunday preaching. But it is not the last time for you. It is the beginning of your life. This is the beginning of your journey. It is the beginning of your things. Greater things are ahead. Listen to me. This is your time to cry unto God. The Bible says when Hannah was praying, there were no words coming out of the mouth. She was murmuring.
A silent prayer.
Now, if you think your prayer, you don't want the next person to hear it.
Can
you just murmur? Begin to pray, somebody.